Sare ga ma ba da ni sa sa re re ga la ma ma ba da la ni ni sa sa ni ni da da ba ma ma da da re re sa. So basically 12 notes. If you take sa re ga ma, then sa re ga ma ga re sa re sa re ga ma ga re sa ma ga ma re ga re ga sa re sa ga re ga re sa re sa ga re sa re ma ga re sa ma ga ma re sa re ga re sa ga re sa re ma ga re sa ma re ga ma ga re sa re ga sa re ga re sa ma ga sa ga re sa re sa re ga ma re ga ma ga re sa. Non-stop. And it is not pre-composed. So ga re ma ga re sa re ga ma sa ma ga re sa ga re sa re sa ga re sa re ma ga re sa ga re sa re ga sa re sa re ma ga re sa re ma sa re ga sa re sa ga re ga ma ga re sa re ga ga sa re sa ma sa re sa re ga sa re ma ga re sa. Unless and until you can see those notes, you cannot sing those.
As you know, Hindustani music is 90%, I would say, it is improvised. 90%. Because there are like, you know, fixed composition, like this is fixed, dha, then I cannot change that. But we do a lot of ornamentation, between and the way, you know, the tabla developed. And that's why it is such a most popular, I think, the, you know, percussion instrument in the world. And these days you can see in the world music scene, jazz, everywhere you can see tabla is using. Because I think one of the main reason is, when you say something, you can get the same feel, same sound from the instrument. That's really amazing. Like if I say some bowl, like, you know, phrase, kata kata ghenana adhi ghenna. It's like very weird to you, but you get the same feel with the tabla. You can say, take tum na keta takta. You know, it's amazing that one, that's the best part of the tabla, it's so dynamic that when you say something,
see, in spite of having the same skill, in spite of having the same skill, how the mood or the how the emotion will be different. So we are taking three ragas. One is called Marwa, one is called Puriya, and the last one is called Sohini. Marwa, Puriya and Sohini. Dhani re ga re ga re ni dha ma ra sa.
Money, that.
Marwa. Now, having the same notes combination, Puriya is different. Ne, ne.
Composition
मंदर जे Improvising the composition, and we are coming back to the first beat. Mandare
Salamani.
gradually we are going towards the climax, the faster part. Khan, now using the compositions, using the lyric which we called Rul Khan.
Thank you.
which we call Samal Java. See, the first difficult thing is to master the swaras, to master the notes. If I do any mistake singing the sargam, then nobody will accept me as a performer. So first of all, you have to master the notes so that whenever you sing any kind of raga, you don't do any mistakes while singing the sargams. It should be very clear, it should be very visible to all of you and visible to the performer first. And then the most difficult thing to understand the raga, the essence, the mood. You cannot sing each and every taan and sargam in a particular raga. So you have to restrain yourself. And you have to listen to it, listen to the great maestros, how they have performed. So in that way, you can gather some knowledge from them and you can adopt those and then you can perform. It's not like you learn any raga and start performing. Before that, you have to listen to those ragas sung or performed by great maestros. And of course, you need to train your voice so that you can go up to a certain level in the lower octave and the upper octaves as well. So you need to have a good range of voice so that you can
basically use. You have to, you know,
and
you have to be skillful.
And the last but not the least, but it is the most essential part of learning or understanding music, Indian music, which is to have a good sense of rhythm, good sense of taal, because taal is the base. I mean, it is the serving plate on which you are serving the food. If you don't have plates, then you cannot serve your food. So the taal is considered as the serving plate or the pot.
And I would like to also add a couple of things. Like, you know, you must have been noticed when I was accompanying him with the malkos, that rag he was presenting with. And you can see he was developing the rag, at the same time he was also speeding up, you know. That is kind of a nature of our music. It's not like we start with some particular speed and finish there. We do sometimes, that not necessarily happen. But
in the Carnatic style, in the southern part, they have that fixed tempo.
Yeah, normally they fix. But our music, our discipline is more of a natural thing. Like when someone born, then he started scrolling, then he start to walk, then he started walking, then, you know, running kind of thing. It's just with the nature we do. And as a, you know, rhythm player, as a tabla player, when I was accompanying, my job also, that is very interesting. Of course, I was keeping the rhythm, you know, time cycle, I was keeping. When he was improvising, at the same time, I was also responding with such a manner, it should go with the rag and the character of his music. That is very important. It's not that anything I can play in 16-bit. It has to match with the character of the, you know, singing, which is very important, and that we try to follow. This is very important thing in our music. So I hope that you kind of notice that we are kind of interacting, but not like, you know, overlapping, or you have to just the subject I have chosen, that it should match with the singing. That is very important.
So it is like a conversation with both of you, and whenever someone talks, the other one has to listen to that, and it will be vice versa as well.
At the same time, he was asked to try to tell that, you know, if when you ask what's your name, I should not say I live in India. So that's what he's saying. I'm just kidding. So, anyway, I think, Dr. Bhaiya, do you think that what we are going to end this session? It is 9 o'clock almost, I think, yeah.
Yes,
so,
yeah, I think if anybody has any further questions,
yeah, I think
they'll hang out for a few minutes. But thank you guys very much for coming.
Thank you so much for giving us this opportunity to be here and to share our knowledge with you. But it was time was a little short, but I hope you could
time
understand.
2 hours, you know, I think if you have to have 3 hours, nobody's going to come. 2 hours is, I think, it's
so,
long.
I hope
we could. Future, if we get an opportunity, we can come, we can even share more, you know, details.
And we can also learn something from you as well, because see, we all are students, and till our last breath, we have to be like a student. If we think that we have learned everything, then there is no scope of learning. So there is so much to learn and so much to invent, so much to cultivate. So much.
Thank you.
Good night.